everyone. I hope you all are fit and fine at your homes. So stay at home and don't go outside. And make use of washing your hands with soaps and using sanitizers to keep your hands clean so that you are not getting infected by anything. So today we'll start Standard 8 Science. We'll do revision on lesson number 1, that is Living World and Classification of Microbes. So see, in this we had seen the five kingdom classification method that was given by Whittaker. So see here, in the exercise also you have that. So if you are going to classify living organisms, so here you will have living organisms. So this is there in your exercise also. So from here, it is classified into two. So here you will have the prokaryotes. On this side you will have the eukaryotes. Then in prokaryotes you will have the unicellular made up of one cell. In eukaryotes you have unicellular and multicellular. So here we have unicellular and multicellular. So here we will have multicellular. Now in unicellular you will have kingdom mammalia. So here we will have mammalia. Here you will have protista. In multicellular you will have fungi, plants and then animals. So here you will have fungi, kingdom plantae or plants, and kingdom animalia or animals. So you will write kingdom plantae and kingdom. So now what we have done in the earlier class, so there we had seen the Whittaker's five kingdom classification. So here he divided the living organisms into five groups: Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animals. So depending upon that, so what was consideration there was complexity of cell structure, whether it is prokaryotes or eukaryotes. Like eukaryotes, they have a well-defined cell nucleus with cell organelles, and it is absent in prokaryotes. Then complexity of organisms, unicellular or multicellular, one made up of one cell or multicellular means made up of many cells. And mode of nutrition, you have plants. Those who are autotrophic, that is photosynthetic, those who can prepare their own food. Fungi, they are saprophytic, means they absorb or they feed on the dead decaying matter. Animals, they are heterotrophic and ingestive. Ingestive means heterotrophic and ingestive, that means they depend on others, like they depend on plants. Now like lifestyles, they have plants, animals and fungi. Now plants, they are the producers, because the living world, like animals, they depend on them. So animals, they are the consumers, they will eat the plants, and the plants are the producers. So fungi are the decomposers, they decompose the dead decay. Now phylogenetic relationship, that is prokaryotic to eukaryotic, that is from unicellular we have evolved to multicellular. Now these is what is given in your exercise. So this way you will classify into living organisms into prokaryotes, eukaryotes, then unicellular, multicellular. Then eukaryotes are further divided into unicellular, multicellular, and then further into both, they are divided into the five kingdoms. Now see here, if you see, here it is for match the pairs. First one is fungi, then it is protozoa, virus, algae and bacteria. So see here, in the B option you have chlorella, bacteriophage, candida, amoeba and prokaryotic. So fungi is nothing but candida, protozoa. Protozoa example is what? Amoeba. Virus is bacteriophage. Bacteriophage means virus which attacks bacteria. So here it is. Bacteriophage. Chlorella is for algae. And bacteria is prokaryotic. So this is the match the following what you have in the exercise. Now further we will see straight true or false. So in that first one, lactobacilli are harmful bacteria. So it is false. Lactobacilli are not harmful bacteria. They are useful bacteria because they are useful for curdling of milks and they are used for making many, you know, dairy products from milk. So for that purpose lactobacilli are important. So they are not harmful, they are useful. Cell wall of fungi is made up of chitin. Now see, cell wall of plants, it is made up of cellulose, and cell wall of fungi, it is made up of that complex sugar known as chitin, and in that you will find many nucleus are present in the cytoplasm. Then we have organs of locomotion in amoeba is pseudopoda. Now it is pseudopoda, that T is silent, so it is true. In amoeba the organ of locomotion is pseudopoda only. Now tomato wilt is a viral disease. It is true, tomato wilt is a viral disease. And these diseases, they affect the only plant cells which affects the tomato plant. So it is true. So the only false is the first one, that is lactobacilli are harmful bacteria. Now if you see, who am I? See, I don't have true nucleus, cell organelles or plasma membrane, that are the microbes from the Monera kingdom. They don't have a true nucleus, a cell organelles or plasma membrane. Then I have nucleus and membrane bound cell organelles, that is protozoas, protozoans from the protista, or you can say the eukaryotes. They have the well-defined nucleus and the cell organelles. I live on dead decaying organic matter. These are the saprophytes, the fungi. They depend on the decaying organic matter. I reproduce mainly by cell division. It can be protozoans or bacteria who divide by cell division. I can reproduce my replica, that is virus. Viruses, they produce the replica. I am green but I don't have organs, that is algae. So we'll see little bit characteristics. Now bacteria, they have size 1 micrometers to 10 micrometers. They are unicellular, independent, parasitic organisms. Sometimes many bacteria together form colonies. So they live together and they form colonies. Now see here, they are given in the figure Coccus, Cocobacillus, Bacillus, Vibrio, that is comma shape, and Spirillum. So these are all the shapes of the bacteria. The bacterial cell is prokaryotic cell with cell wall, but distinct nucleus or cell organelles are absent. So they have a cell wall, but distinct nucleus and the organelles which are present in the cell, that are not there, they are absent. Now they reproduce simply by binary fission. They reproduce by binary fission. It divides, one nucleus will divide into two daughter nuclei. Now in favorable conditions, bacteria grow vigorously and can double their numbers in 20 minutes. So if the condition is favorable, temperature is favorable, environment is conducive for them, so they will grow double the numbers in 20 minutes. Now we'll see the protozoa. Now their size is approximately 200 micrometers. turtles. So protozoans, they are found in soil, fresh water and sea water. So where they are found in soil, fresh water and sea water. Sea water is the marine water, salt water. Now some are found in the body of other organisms and are pathogenic. Now these protozoans, they are found in the body of other organisms, they are pathogens. Pathogens means disease causing. So they are harmful. Now these are unicellular organisms with eukaryotic cells. Unicellular, made of one cell, eukaryotic, well-defined nucleus is present. There is great variation in the cell structure, organs of locomotion and the modes of nutrition. So all these things, many different differences are there in all these things of locomotion or modes of nutrition or cell structure among the protozoans. These organisms, they reproduce by simple cell division. Now example, amoeba, paramecium, they are free living in dirty water. Then we have entamoeba, histolytica, which causes amoebiasis. Now that is a parasitic infection which is caused by amoeba. Plasmodium vivax, that causes malaria. Euglena, it is autotrophic. Autotrophic means it can prepare its own food. Then we'll see fungi. Its size is approximately 10 micrometers to 100 micrometers. These are found on decaying organic matter and dead bodies of plants and animals. So fungi, they are saprotrophs. They depend upon the decaying organic matter. So it means when the animals are dead, they decompose that. These are eukaryotic organisms. Some are unicellular and others are visible by naked eye. So multicellular, so we can they are visible by naked eye also. We can see like this also. We don't need microscope to see them. And some are unicellular, so for that we need microscope and we will not be able to see with our naked eyes. Saprotrophic, absorb their food from decaying organic matter. This we have said earlier. They reproduce sexually and asexually by cell division or by budding, or by cell division. Baker's yeast, candida and mushroom. So these are the example of fungi which of the candida was there in the match the pairs. Algae, approximately 10 micrometers to 100 micrometers. Now they are aquatic, means they live in water. Eukaryotic, unicellular, autotrophic organisms made up of one cell. Autotrophic means they can prepare their own food. And photosynthesis is carried out with the help of chloroplast in the cell. Now chloroplast is a place where the photosynthesis takes place. It is a site of photosynthesis. An example, it is called chlorella and chlamydomonas. Very few species of algae are unicellular. So very few species are unicellular, means made up of one cell. Most of them are multicellular and visible with the naked eye. Multicellular means made up of more than one cell and we can see with our eyes. Now we'll see viruses, approximately 10 nanometers to 100 nanometers. Now generally viruses are not considered as living organisms, or they are said to be organisms at the edge of living or non-living. So they are not living. So they are considered at the edge of living also and non-living also. They are not living. They are studied under microbiology. So viruses, they are studied under the branch microbiology, which is a branch of science. Now viruses are extremely minute. They are 10 to 100 times smaller than bacteria. It is in nanometers. They are very small and can be seen only with electron microscope. So electron microscope is used to see viruses because they are very very minute. They are found in the form of independent particles. Viruses is a long molecule of DNA or RNA covered by a protein coat. So it is just a DNA or RNA molecule covered with a protein coat. That is a virus. Now, viruses, now what is DNA? DNA is deoxyribonucleic acids. In our body, the genetic material is DNA. RNA is ribonucleic acid. Now, viruses survive only on living plant or animal cells and produce their own proteins with the help of the host cell and create their numerous replica. So, with the help of the host cell, they create their numerous replica. They then destroy the host cell and become free. These free viruses again infect new cells and then they again infect the new cells. So viruses cause many diseases to plants and animals and they are very harmful. So I hope you have understood this chapter. Read the textbook and solve the answers. Thank you.